Hi everyone, I'm GP Vahan, fantasy artist, illustrator, and welcome to my channel. Here, we will bring you a ton of content where I will be working with acrylic, pen and ink, pencil drawing, and a variety of other mediums. These shows will incorporate fantasy, culture, music, symbols, and basically be entertaining and fun. This channel is all about creating and having fun with art. For me personally, art is a never-ending adventure. It's another way of growth and self-discovery. So come with me, join me, and subscribe to my channel, and we will bring you more content. The button's right there. Have fun watching. Enjoy.
On September 20th, 2017, the center of Hurricane Maria, a nearly Category 5 hurricane, made a direct hit on Puerto Rico. The island was pummeled with rain and wind for more than 30 hours, causing tornado-like damage. The island's entire electrical infrastructure was destroyed. Trees were uprooted, roofs were ripped off houses, bridges were swept away, and more. The municipality of Moca in the far northwest of Puerto Rico suffered massive destruction. Rotary District 7910 partnered with the Liberty New York Rotary Club and the Moca Rotary Club, Puerto Rico, to organize a hurricane relief mission. This mission was a cooperative effort between Operation Endeavor, the Wings of Michael, and the Rotary to provide relief to areas devastated by Hurricane Maria. The focus of the trip was on reconstruction, providing flu and tetanus vaccinations, and toy distribution to children who sustained total losses during the hurricane. The Moca Rotary Club, under their president, Nelson Quinones, identify the relief recipients and purchase needed items in Puerto Rico to help the local economy. Nelson enlisted help from Father Juan and Father Caro from Nuestra Señora de la Monserrate. Don Luis's entire home was demolished by Maria. He's been living in a shack adjacent to the ruins of his house as he attempts to rebuild. He has no running water and no electricity. Funds were used to purchase supplies for the rebuild. On Saturday, we worked to turn the area from a disaster site into a viable construction zone.
If you're like me and like a low-profile keyboard but can't find a good one when under a budget, then I've found the keyboard for you. The Cougar Vantar, or Vantair, is one of the best low-profile keyboards that I have found, and after almost a week of being used, I prefer it over my old Corsair Strafe, which was starting to wear down after being used for only a few years. The first thing that's noticeable is that it's almost like a laptop with a thin but sturdy design. It has a brushed aluminum feel even though it is made from plastic, which I do find as a downside. It comes with 8 color options that are all available without software as they are all built into the keyboard. 1 is a rainbow effect, 2 is a blocky rainbow effect, 3 is fading colors, 4 is a streak effect, 5 is just a solid color, 6 is a weird effect that I cannot describe, 7 is make your own, and 8 is a ripple effect. The keys are not individually lit up, but that is expected from the price point. The keys are nice and responsive and even have the laptops found.
Hi, I'm Natasha Grableski and I'm the owner of Bar 3 Bedford and Bar 3 Sudbury. We're super excited to bring you another 30-minute workout today. You'll need a mat, an optional handheld pair of weights. Let's get started. Starting off in primary posture, bring your feet right underneath your hips. Give a little bend in the knees. Draw your abs up and under your rib cage. Relax the shoulders down your back. Yeah, let's just breathe together. Inhale, reach your arms all the way up. Exhale, let the spine go all the way down. Inhale, step the feet a little wider.
Later in the evening, as you lie awake in bed, with the echoes of the amplifiers ringing in your head, you smoke the day's last cigarette. remembering what you said. So here I am. Stage, here I go, playing star again. There I go, turn the page. Ah, here I am, on the road again. There I am, up on the stage.
My name is Johnny Vaught, and this is The Review, where I review the latest and the greatest movies for Bedford TV. This is a very special episode, one that I've been looking forward to for so long. I have my favorite co-host in. I have my lovely wife, Alice, with me today. We are going to be discussing Mary Poppins Returns, and I'm really excited to get into this movie. I have seen it once. Alice has actually seen it two times. Just going to talk a few things about the movie, and then we're going to get into the review. Mary Poppins Returns is actually the longest gap between an original movie and the sequel in cinematic history. There were 54 years between the first one and Mary Poppins Returns.
I really, really enjoyed it. I saw it with you, and then you had some time when you were working during Christmas break, and I had some time when I wasn't working, and just took myself right back and saw it again. So I had a great time. I think from the first moment I was smiling, and then I felt like I was every other song, I was either like grinning or crying or both, and I loved it.
Well done, Dylan. I'm Dan Broskell here with Dylan Bradford on Halloween Eve. Is that right?
I think so.
And what do you what's your costume in case we can't figure it out?
Poison Ivy.
Oh, and I am something. What am I? I'm a bear ears. Is that what this is?
I can't tell.
I'm a wolf.
Award-winning wolf
with my lifetime achievement. This is actually not the World Series trophy, but we'll get to that in a moment. But we're doing a little backwards day because it's Halloween Eve. Start with sports. So welcome to the sports report for Monday, October 29th, 2018. It is maybe the greatest sports report ever, Dylan. So you're very lucky to be here.
And now out to Maria outside for more weather. Summer weather, I hope not winter.
Thank you. Now that I am outside, back in my natural habitat, I will bring you the weather here for the final time. Since this is my last weather report, I'll give you the forecast for the next 100 years in my absence.
To another edition of Celebrate Life. My name's Wayne Braverman. I'm yours for the next half hour, I think. It is my sad honor and privilege to have with me Greg Dolan, who we are recording this on, sadly, his very, very last day at Bedford TV.
It's very sad.
Greg, do you need a tissue or something?
No, I'll be all right. I'm sad to leave, right. But I feel like I'm leaving Bedford TV in a good place, which is nice, and I'm excited for my next gig. So,
and your next gig will mean less traffic.
First off, my name is Mr. Tracy. I am the principal here at John Glenn Middle School, and I've been here for 7 years. Very excited to be starting another school year. Welcome.
So at JGMS, we have a six-day cycle. So that means that students have 6 days a week that they see certain classes. So we have 5 days a week in the week, and when students have 6 days, that means if they start a class on a Monday, that's day one, and then the following Monday is going to be on a day six.
On average, I give about 20 to 25 minutes of homework a night. If your homework takes you longer than 20 to 25 minutes, you just let me know, and I think 20 to 25 minutes is more than enough, so I'll have you stop after that.
I will be honest, we do have more homework than fifth grade, fourth grade, third grade, but it's not unbearable. So you're not like, oh my God, I have so much homework. You're like, yeah, I have homework, yeah.
Hi, my name is Haley Weissman. I'm the producer of this film, and I figured that I'd show you guys how to open a locker, because that is a question a lot of people have when first going into middle school, and even I had that question when I was first entering sixth grade. So I'm just going to be showing you on my own locker. My combination is 41, 47, 31, so let's get started. So you're going to start by clearing out the lock, and you're going to do that by doing just a few rounds to the right.
Next award goes to Best Cameo. So this was for a person that was kind of a fish out of water, as we called it last year, and they were thrown into a completely different show that they had never had any experience with before, and sometimes it ended up being funny, sometimes they ended up doing a really good job. So let's watch some of those instances.
Johnny Vaught, Sports Scholars with Johnny Vaught.
The Lakers do historically have one of the more like V-shaped uniforms, but I just hate the like.
He just needs the gold chain and some chest hair. He'd be perfect.
Honestly, if they could wear gold while they were playing like in the NFL, it would be a very different thing. But because they don't wear helmets, I don't think they need to accessorize as much to be known.
I gotcha.
Wow.
So I'll say this.
Stylist Johnny for you.
I never thought of that, Johnny.
This is, yeah, man, for sure. That's awesome. I mean, they're decked out in accessories to be more known.
And Siemens. The Wrestling Connection.
It was a very action-packed, because like I said, you had the first ever Women's Royal Rumble, and something I know that Julie, our Big Four pay-per-view champion, was very, very, very excited about, especially what happened after the end. So, you know what, even though it was the main event.
Al Fay, Bedford TV News.
So we have guest reporter Al Fay here doing the sports report.
Okay,
what do you want to let us know?
Red Sox just signed up J.D. Martinez for the Red Sox.
Oh,
a five-year deal.
5 years? Wow. Yeah.
Clapping for you over there.
How is his salary?
His salary's good for 5 years.
All right, and the winner for best cameo is... Al Fay.
Each class
last 45 minutes and is a high-intensity interval training style workout. Exercises range from squats and lunges to the more challenging burpees and mountain climbers. Despite this, trainers insist that your exercise level shouldn't deter you from trying out the class.
The Tough Mudder Bootcamp is infinitely scalable, whether you're an experienced athlete or a beginner. Somebody just coming off the couch, the Tough Mudder Bootcamp workout is right for you.
Although Burlington is currently the only operating location, 30 units have already been sold in places like Florida, California, and New York. Finding a location to fit the studios in can be fairly easy, with each boot camp being only 2,000 to 3,000 square feet. Despite the small size, organizers and trainers hope to inspire its members through challenging and fierce workouts.
It was amazing. It was challenging, it was fun, there was a lot of teamwork. It was great. You should come check it out.
Okay, we have a few items tonight. First is an out-of-state field trip being sponsored by Michael Griffin along with a female chaperone, because there'll be 22 students, grades 9 to 12. They intend to take them to the Merck Forest and Farmland in Rupert, Vermont. It is both out-of-state and overnight. Educational aim of the field trip is to have students participate in workshops that are focused around sustainability and energy conservation on the farm. Activities are designed with the resident forester and farmer. It's a great trip. They've done this before.
Well, what should we do now?
Let's check the place out. I don't see what's so scary about it.
Good idea. The studio is right this way and all of the lights are on. So while they are all on, we should be safe in town and I won't be hiding in my hood like a little wimp.
That's scary, huh? I like that idea.
Good.
This place is incredible.
Pretty nifty.
And then I could be a Chris Rock.
Check one, check two. These.
Hello, anyone here?
Wow. What is this?
Wow, this stuff is so cool.
Hey, what do you say? Try something out. It looks like this camera's already on.
I don't think you should touch that.
Yeah, well, whoop-dee-doo. All right, now I'm going to turn you into Elmo. Now, what do you think of that? All right, 3, 2, 1. Ah! Where's everyone gone? Okay, guys? Hello? Hello? Is anyone there? That's not good. Oh, jeez. Maybe there's a weapon somewhere over here to fend off killers.
Ah!
Clyde, what was that for? Dang it! Come back! Wait!
I'm leaving. This is way too scary for me.
But you can't! Besides, we're gonna lose the $10,000 and the donut and the trip to Paris and possibly our lives because Greg's out there.
No, he's not. Look!
Oh my god! Oh no! Oh god!
Hurry, you're right. Let's find them. Besides, I really want those donuts.
And I don't want my life lost.
Why is that door closed? What's behind it?
I don't know, and I want to find out. What are you guys doing?
We're making a show about video games. What are you guys doing?
Touring at Bedford TV today.
I can't get this in focus.
My help is needed. Let me help with this. This should help.
Oh no!
What camera do I put it on?
I'll help you.
Can somebody help me? I forget how to do this.
I can help.
Where did you come from?
You should be a mentor at Bedford TV's.